The latest Marquette University Law School poll has been released, and we're joined today by Professor Charles Franklin, the director of the poll. Charles, the presidential race coming down to the wire. Wisconsin's still thought to be an important state. What did we have for our final poll, pre-election poll?
Yeah, our last pre-election poll. President Obama has retaken a lead to 51-43, recovering from that bad first debate performance that really hurt him here to come back to a significant lead.
Let's talk about the Senate race, another very competitive race, important to which party controls the majority in Washington. What did we find there?
There, Representative Tammy Baldwin has taken a slim lead by 47-43 over former Governor Tommy Thompson. That race was tied 2 weeks ago as well.
Charles, we're seeing some movement in numbers again with the president's numbers. We saw him earlier this summer having a pretty solid lead over Mitt Romney. That tightened, especially, obviously, in our last poll. He's now got a larger lead. Does that have to do with what happened during the three debates?
I think it clearly does. If you look at the course of the campaign, Obama went from a mid to upper single-digit lead and then fell dramatically to just a one-point lead following the first debate. Now, recovering from that, we're seeing a real effect. In our data for Wisconsin voters, 58% saw him as the winner of the third presidential debate, that final debate. Only 31% saw Mitt Romney winning that debate.
This election, like all elections, comes down to turnout. And we have data that suggests that the turnout is especially key in what takes place in Wisconsin Tuesday.
Here we see some really striking differences depending on whether all likely voters get to the polls, or whether only the most energized and interested likely voters do. That 8-point Obama lead drops to just a 2-point lead, 48-46, among those likely voters who are absolutely the most engaged. Likewise, in the Senate race, it falls to just a 1-point Baldwin lead among those most engaged voters. So this issue of turnout is not only turning out your likely voters, but turning out those likely voters who say that for sure they're going to vote, but haven't been paying as much attention or not as engaged by the election.
And both parties say they have great get-out-the-vote operations. Republicans say we built some great infrastructure with the recall election. Democrats say we still got a campaign in place from 4 years ago. We're ready to go.
And we see that in the data. More than two-thirds of voters say they've been contacted by one or the other party in the last week. And that's a very high percentage in just a short period of time. The phones are ringing off the hooks.
Charles Franklin is the director of the Marquette Law School Poll. Thanks very much.
Thank you.